team. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Well, that was definitely a surprise there. Handed to the big guy on first down. Heck, the first play of the drive. And when you see him get to the second level, as a former safety, I can just tell you, your eyes get really wide because you know you've got a lot to deal with at that point.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy. They didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
Now Wilson on 2nd down. It's caught outright by Graham. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. You know, Charles, for Graham, so much concern early in the season about whether he'd be ready to play this year, what would happen recovering from the tendon. Not only was he ready, he played every game this season for Seattle.
And it wasn't just the injury concern with Jimmy Graham. It's how Seattle runs their offense. Remember, when he was in New Orleans, he could expect a ton of passes to come his way. But in Seattle, that number was going to be reduced. Would he be able to maximize what they were going to throw in his direction? And he certainly did this year, 65 catches.
65 catches, just shy of 1,000 yards, 6 touchdowns, too. In the slot on the right is Graham. On 2nd down, Wilson. And this is caught at the 8. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Earlier, partner, when discussing Russell Wilson, you said you think he's best when Seattle is running back-centric. Is Thomas Rawls the centerpiece going forward there?
I think so, because of what he did 2 seasons ago before he got hurt. Because he runs that offense the way they want it run. One cut, downhill, upfield, and Thomas Rawls is perfect for that. If he stays healthy, that allows Russell Wilson now to throw the play action to bootleg passes that really hurt other teams defensively.
And Rawls has youth on his side, just 23. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On 3rd and goal, Wilson, that's caught at the 2. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that will bring up an interesting decision here on 4th and goal.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. So Wilson will head to the sideline, and on comes Steven Hauschka for the field goal. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And Hauschka's kick is good. And they take a 17-14 lead. So it's an old school extra point, but certainly a disappointment that they couldn't get 6.
Yeah, when you see 19-yard field goal in the box score, you kind of shake your head. But their head coach decided 3 was enough.
And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
but it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Josh Huff, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point
kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
So bad. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Alteron Werner. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Following the interception, Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to succeed.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. First down, Winston. Over the middle to Evans. 23 yards on the play. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. From the red zone now, Winston. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Throwing again, Winston on second and 10. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Vincent Jackson, as the first half is winding down, and the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And out now come the Seahawks. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They come out here in the eye. The drive begins with a run by Rawls. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Room here to run, and they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns them a fresh set of downs.
And that's how you run the football and run it successfully. Big-time chunk of yardage picked up, but why? Offensive lineman won at the point of attack. Their leverage way better than the defenders. The low man wins when you're getting underneath and trying to move people. And that's exactly what happened on that play. The offensive line moved the defensive front, created space, and the end result, a fantastic run.
Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Call it a gain of four, and it'll leave him with a third down and six to go.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
On third down, Winston. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot, but they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jude I.J. Barema. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone. Well, after watching them ring the bell that many times and put the ball in the end zone, throwing it, you had to figure they had to bring some type of pressure. They had to change things up on defense.
And able to get to him, put him on the ground, so maybe just something to throw him off a little bit.
Yeah, that had to feel a lot better for the defensive guys. They've been getting carved up in this one. To finally knock him on the ground and force an incompletion, that's got to be a sigh of relief.
On second down, Winston again. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
You gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give him some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. Jameis to throw it. And now another one thrown incomplete.
So the defense forces a three and out, but they got some help along the way. They threw it on first down, and when they were unsuccessful, it became second and long. didn't get it again on another pass, went third and long, and they almost had to put it in the air. They may want to rethink some strategy going forward.
And now a fair catch called for, and he'll indeed take it at about the 6-yard line. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. And not great starting field position here for the offense. In the slot on the right is Graham. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. On second down, here's Wilson. It's caught outright by Graham. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game, throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Now that's a good chunk of yardage picked up there. And big fella, sometimes you need a whole lot of space created. He can make his own way.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Brandon, you know how we talk about having wrinkles in a game plan? That was a fold right there. How about that play? Being able to change things up. You think anyone else on the team's going to get the ball? And in that situation, they surprise everyone and give it to their big guy.
And he's got Rome. Past the 20. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Thomas Rawls, 65 yards. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Added in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of...
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Alteron Werner. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. And a 10th carry here for Martin. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Back now in Tampa. It's the Bucs. They've got the football. They also are in front here on the scoreboard as we start the 4th.
And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, 6 on the field. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on 3rd and short. But sometimes.
And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. Time running out here on the play clock. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. Here's Brian Anger now as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. Returnable for Lockett. That'll be a 50-yard punt with 8 on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. Now Wilson on second down. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. In the slot on the right is Graham. First down, this is Rawls. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
On just about every team, okay, forget it. On every team, the goal is to be in 3rd and what they call manageable.
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Lavonte David. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
Then they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Second down, Winston. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Halfback sent in motion. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Here's Winston. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on 4th down and 9. The play clock's running down. Winston steps away. And no, it's incomplete. The Bucs try it on 4th down but come up empty. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. As Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Time starting to run out here in the fourth. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football. They'll run for it now. Here's Marcel Reese. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the offense has it first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and 6.
Good solid gain on first down, about what you'd expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
In the slot on the right is Graham. He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Brad McDougal. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They have the lead, still a one possession game, but the defense got the stop. They got, and now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Winston gives to the tailback, Martin. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. 8 yards still remaining here on third down. Toss play to Sims. And some space here. And he takes it all the way down to